Hi students, welcome back to today's class. Today we are going to see the new lesson, that is Unit 3, Relational Database Management Systems. So under this, we are going to see the first session today, that is appreciating the concept of database management system. So what are the usefulness of database management system that we will see one by one. So let us move on to the topic. So what is meant by database? Database is an organized collection of data. That is arranged collection of data. It is going to be organized in one format, that is in a tabular format. We can store the data like rows and columns. No, all the informations are going to be stored. Okay, so a database is an organized collection of data. You can visualize it as a container of information. So it is like a storage area. So we can store many information inside that. Okay, so like that you can visualize it as a container of information. The data is typically organized to model relevant aspects of reality. That is, for example, aspects of reality in the sense, if you want to find out how many rooms are available in the hotels, that you can check it with the help of, that is a called one type of data. That is, availability of room is one type of data that you can get it by using this database software. And in a way that it supports processes requiring this information. So whatever information requires these processes, for that also it is giving a support. Okay, so finding a hotel with vacancies. So whichever hotel are there with vacancies, with the room vacancies, that also we can get it from this database concepts. Suppose if you own a stationery shop, that is if you are having a stationery shop, you need to keep the detailed records of the materials available in your shop. So you need to compulsorily maintain whatever materials are available, that materials and all you need to maintain as a record. Okay, so you also need to store information about pricing. That means that materials price and stock levels for reordering and old stocks, etc., you can store. Okay, and while in the manual system, if you check, you would maintain several files with different bits of information. So you need to maintain different files, no? Several files you need to maintain. So in the computerized system, you would use database programs such as Microsoft Access. So if you go for computerized system instead of manual system, you need to have database programs such as what? MS Access, OpenOffice ArcBase, and then MySQL. These are the database software examples. To organize the data as per our business needs. So if you want to arrange the data or store data in a database programs, you can use this software. That is my MS Access, OpenOffice ArcBase, and MySQL software. You can make use of it. Okay. The database concept has evolved since the 1960s to ease increasing difficulties in designing, building, and maintaining complex information systems. That means there are difficulties in designing the information system, building the, that is making the information system, and maintaining the information system. So that difficulties and all is going to be overcome by this introduction of what? Database software concepts. Okay. And because of concurrent end users, because these information systems are going to be used by many users, they need to have lot of data also. They need to refer a lot of information from that information systems. So with a large amount of diverse data and with many concurrent end users, database softwares only will be very much supportable in order to get the information. Okay. So in this lesson, we will learn database concepts and to work with the database management system. So what is the full form of DBMS? Is database management system. So it is a software package. DBMS is a software package with computer programs. Okay, so it will be having a computer programs. The collection of computer programs is known as what? Software. So it is a software package with computer programs that controls the creation of the database and maintenance of the database and use of the database. So that controls the creation, maintenance, and use of the database. It allows organizations to conveniently develop databases for various applications. So for the different applications, convenient way the users, end users need to make use of this developed databases. So for that, it is allowing the organizations to conveniently develop the databases for various applications. A database is an integrated collection of data records, files, and other objects. So a database, otherwise we can define as what? It is an integrated collection of data records, files, and other objects. A DBMS allows different user application programs to concurrently access the same database. So database management system software, it is allowing different user application programs, okay, to simultaneously access or make use of the same database. Well-known DBMS softwares includes Oracle, IBM DB2, Microsoft SQL Server, Microsoft Access, PostgreSQL, MySQL, Fox Pro, and SQLite. So these are the, some of the well-known DBMS softwares. So data can be organized into two types. So how we can organize the database into two types? One is flat file database and another one is relational database. In a flat file database, data is stored, going to be stored in a single table. So as a single table, data is going to be stored. Usually it is suitable for storing less amount of data. Flat file is always used to store less amount of data. Example is MS Excel. Okay, MS Excel, that is spreadsheet application software you are using, no? That is an example for single, that is flat file database. Next one is relational database. So data is going to be stored in multiple tables and the tables are linked using the common field. So for several tables, one single common field, that is field name means column name, is going to be taken. So using that column name, that is every table, if you have around three tables, the three tables also will be having the same field. Okay, so with that help of that same field, we can make the tables to connect with each other. So we can make a link between the tables. So relational database is suitable for medium to large amount of data. So in order to store medium or to large amount of data, we can use this relational database. Next term, database servers. So database servers are the dedicated computers, okay, that hold the actual databases. So database servers are dedicated computers. Already it is assigned for holding database softwares and databases alone. Okay, so database servers are dedicated computers that hold the actual databases and it runs only the DBMS and its related software. Typically, databases available on the database servers are accessed through command line or graphical user interface tools, that is referred to as front end. So command line and GUI is referred to as what? Front end. So with the help of the front end only, the database software which is available at the back end or database server which is available at the back end is going to be accessed. So here, database servers are referred to as backend. Such type of data access is referred to as client-server model. So in this method, if we are accessing the data, that is going to be referred to as client-server model. So client side, we have the command line or graphical user interface, and in the server side, we have the database server. Next topic is RDBMS. So what is the full form of RDBMS? Relational Database Management System. So it is a database management system that is based on the relational model as introduced by E.F. Codd of IBM's San Jose Research Laboratory. So he was a researcher in the IBM San Jose Research Laboratory. So this RDBMS was introduced by E.F. Codd. Okay, it is based on the relational model. Okay. Most popular databases currently in the use are based on this relational database model only. So most of the popular databases, already we have seen some of the DBMS, no, like PostgreSQL, MySQL, MS Access, and then like Oracle, IBM DB2, Fox Pro, all those softwares, MS Access, all those are currently maximum softwares are based on popular databases are using relational database model only. Okay. Next, the purpose of relational model is, okay, what is the purpose of relational model? It is used to provide declarative method for specifying data and queries. So we can use some kind of query declarative methods in order to specify the data and to make a query in the database. Okay, so users directly state what information the database contains and what information they want from it, and let the database management system software take care of describing data structures for storing the data and for retrieving procedures for answering the queries. So some of the commands we are going to have in maximum database softwares in order to. So that is the main advantage of this relational model. So it is giving declarative method for specifying data and the queries. Next one is database concepts. So database, it contains objects that are used for storing and managing the information. And to understand the database in a very simple language, let's look at some of the examples of one of your address book. So what do you store in the address book? You may have a pupil name, pupil's address and pupil phone number, and maybe even pupil birthdays. There is a common element here, pupil. So here the pupil, each person is going to be considered as an item or table name. Okay, so item is otherwise called as table name. Okay, so an item is what the database is storing information about. So item means what the database is storing information about. So the database is going to store information about which one? About item. Okay, that is only item. Item is called as, okay. When you were recording information in your address book, what did you ask the people? What is your address? What is your phone number, etc.? For all these questions, whatever questions we are asking about our item is called a field. That is phone number, address, and then name. All those things are called as field name or column name in a table. So first term we have got as item. Item is otherwise called as table name. And field name we need to have. Okay, so if you are going to ask questions, that questions are related to every column name or field name only. Now you say you make new friends and want to add their information to your address book. So you will ask questions, get the answers, and create a new record. So you will get the information for every field name, and you will store all these informations in one after the other way, so that getting answers and creating a new record. So record is also another important technical term which is there in the database concept. So record is used to indicate the entire answers. Okay, so whatever answers you are typing in a single row, okay, that is only known as record. So collection of records only making a file. So a record is a set of information made up of fields stored in your database about one of the items. Okay, so one particular person's related details, if you are going to have in one particular row, full row horizontally, then that is making a record. A value is the actual text or numerical amount or date that you put in while adding information to your database. So under column name, you will add all the values. You will enter the values. That value may be in the form of numerical amount or actual text value or date value. When you put all the information together in a grid, like you do in the spreadsheet, grid means what? Like row and column representation. A collection of similar records is going to create a table. So similar records, same record, similar type of records are going to create the table. So what is meant by table? A collection of similar records only, it will create a table. A database can have one or many tables. As we have said, relational database means it will be having multiple tables linked with a common field. So database can have one table or a many tables. An address book is an example for very simple one. In real life, there are many more details involved. A big company would have in its database one table for its products and one table for its suppliers and one table for its customer details and one for orders received and maybe many others table also. Like that, a database can have many tables. Each table in a database contains information about one type of an item. So customer details means only customer related information will be there, and product related table means only product related information will be there. So that product is the item. So a database is basically a container that holds tables and other objects and manages how they can be used. So another very important thing you need to remember here is that when we put in information, we may have people with the same name. There can be more than one Charu Arora or the same address. There is members of a family, if you are entering, all the members of a family will be having what? Same address only. So, but when we are creating a database, an important feature is record uniqueness in every table. So whatever table, so many tables if you create also, there should be a feature called record uniqueness. Uniqueness means differently you need to able to pick up one particular row of information or record. Okay. So it is important to be able to distinguish between the different items having duplicate values. So there should not be any column name. We should not have the same value. That is in any record, if you take, there should be a values that should be different. Different values need to be allotted in every record. So uniqueness helps to avoid accidental duplication of records caused by users or computer error. So it is going to avoid what? Accidental duplication of records. This can be achieved by using some number or value that uniquely identifies a record. Okay. So we will have one example related to this uniqueness. After seeing that, you will understand in better way. Okay. So you can create a special additional field in a table where unique numbers. See, if such a unique value does not exist in your fields, no, like name, standard, section. So here there is no unique field. Section A is repeated for how many times? For three records, A is repeated. Standard is repeated for all the persons. Even name of the person also repeated here. So Ravi, with the name Ravi and with initial, same initial, there may be more than one person in particular classroom. So that duplication need to be avoided here. We need to create the uniqueness. So if such unique value does not exist, so in this example table, no, we don't have this uniqueness in the values. Okay. So if such unique value does not exist in your fields, as the database designer, you can create a special additional field in a table where unique numbers or values can be assigned for each new entry. So whatever new entry you are making, you can assign a unique number or value. Therefore, every table has a key field which ensures that there are 100% unique values throughout the database. So we need to assign a unique key field that is known as primary key field. So every database table should have one or more fields designated as a key. Okay, every database table should have one or more fields. One field or more field you can designate, you can assign as a key. Okay, you can allot as a key. You can assign a unique value to this key for differentiating records that may have similar names or addresses. See here in this example also, okay, we have Ravi repeated for how many times? Two times, the name of the person, Ravi, is repeated. Okay, so in this table, it will be extremely difficult to differentiate between the student records as they have names that are similar. To differentiate, you can add additional field that is roll number that will be unique for each record. So whatever field name or column name, if you are able to add, if there is no uniqueness in the table, the database, you can add a new field as a unique field. Okay. So you had used the example of an address book in the previous section. An address book uses only one table, but look at a different situation. If you are a dealer selling a single type of item and want to record details of your, see here in this two examples, no, if you consider these two tables, here Ravi is repeated for two times. So if I want to pick one particular record related to Ravi, so I want information related to Ravi, that is first, second row only I want to get, but two informations are also will be obtained. So in that case, how we can avoid means, see, with the help of roll number, we can take only, so we can pick the, we can use the condition where roll number is equal to 20, like that if you give condition correctly. So based on this roll number field, we can easily extract the second record alone. So this entire set of values, no, which we have at the second row, that is known as one record. So first row also one record. So collection of these records only will make a table, okay, or file. So if you are a dealer, as a dealer selling a single type of an item and want to record details of your sales in the past month, and also want the details of the client who purchased the item, that is name of the person, name of the client, address, client address, client phone, and then date, which date they were purchased, and then number of items bought. Okay, so what would you do? You can create the table sales with the all the details. So this is like a flat file. So here, if you check on particular customer, he'll be buying, he might be buying many items. Okay, so that person's name will be repeated for around three times. See here, order ID 790, Vaibhav Mittal. See in 792 also, Vaibhav Mittal. See here, purchased different items with the different order ID. Okay, so here order ID is unique field, but customer name is repeated for around how many times? Three times Vaibhav Mittal name is repeated. So in order to avoid this duplication, do you see a problem here? Every time you sell an item to Sheila or Vaibhav, see Sheila name also, see Sheela, here also Sheila, that Sheela only need to be written. So here Sheila and Vaibhav, they both, okay, both the customers, need to store the details. Their details are stored here again. So what is the solution for this? Create one more table for client tables and another for sales tables. So for sales tables, we can separate this sale date and items bought alone along with this order ID, and we can maintain separate table for customer details alone. So like that, client table one and sales table another one, like that we need to divide this table into two when we want to obtain uniqueness in every record. Okay, so since each record has to be unique, you can insert the client ID field to uniquely identify each client in the table. In the sales table, you would give a point of reference which points to a particular record in the client table. So in the example here, the field client ID occurs once in the client table, but since one client can place many orders, it occurs number of times in the sales table. So client ID, if you are going to use here in this first table, that is in the client table, and the same client ID is going to be used in the sales table, but the values of the client ID, you know, will be repeated for many times, okay? Because same client may purchase more than one items, no? So, but since one client can place many orders, it occurs a number of times in the sales tables. Since we cannot have an order without a customer, we call client as the parent and sales as the child table. So without client, whether we can make a sale? No. So which table is going to be considered here as a parent table? Client table only is going to be considered here as a parent table. And related tables like these share a common field. So you can store a data about people once, but refers to those people many times in the database. In the child tables, we can refer. So this unique field is called as what? The unique field what we have in the parent table is known as primary key. Okay, primary key is a unique value that identifies a row in a table. So it, with the help of the, what is that? With the help of primary key field, we can identify every row uniquely. Okay. So in our example, client ID is the primary key in the client table. Primary key is also indexed in the database, making it faster for the database to search for a record. Okay, it is also going to be used as an index value in order to search the record fastly. When primary key constraint is applied on one or more columns, then it is known as composite primary key. So primary key is going to be applied for many columns. So if you are going to choose one column as a primary key, that is simply primary key alone, we will say. But if you are going to choose one or more columns as a primary key, then that is known as composite primary key. The refer field client ID, which occurs in the sales table, is called foreign key. So whatever field we are referring in the that is referred field client ID, which occurs in the sales table, no, that is known as foreign key. But the same client ID, which is used in the parent table, that is client table, that is known as primary key. The same field what we are using in the sales table is known as, referred as foreign key there. Okay, so same primary key is going to be called in the child table as what key? Foreign key field. Okay, so hence the foreign key identifies the column or set of columns in one table that refers to a column or set of columns in the referenced table. Okay, so which table are referenced? Both are going to be linked with the help of this foreign key. So when the foreign key identifies a column or set of columns in referencing table that refers to a column or set of columns in the other referenced table, the one side of a relation is always the parent and provides the PK, that is primary key attributes, to be copied. The many side of a relation is always the child into which the foreign key attributes are copied. So we need to memorize that one parent primary key, many means many child foreign key. Okay, so here we can see one example table, that is client table and sales table, whatever till now we have discussed, that is done here. Okay, so in a client table, client ID is separately created. Okay, order ID and the sale date, items bought are written separately. The same client ID is going to be used here in the sales table also. But in the client table, only four clients' names are written here. Their address and phone numbers are written. But if you consider the sales table, that is child table, we have client ID along with the order ID also, because the same client, no, that is second client purchased around three times, and client one also purchased for two times. Okay, so here the client ID is going to be called as, in the sales table, it is called as foreign key, but here it is known as primary key. Okay, in the main table, that is in a parent table, this field is considered to be a primary key field because we have different values only. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4 are different. It is not repeated here. Here also, But in the sales table, that same client ID is going to be repeated. It can be repeated for many times. Okay. But here, with the help of this client ID common field, so this is only known as common field, client ID common field, these two tables, that is client table and sales tables, are going to be linked with each other. So because of this foreign key only, the reference is made to the client table, that is in a parent table. So sales table is depending on the client table or parent table. So whatever updations we are making in the parent table, that should be reflected in the sales table also with the help of this common field, that is client ID. So one client, three orders for that client is done here, denoted here. Okay. So another point to remember is that the end users may never have direct access to the database. End users, that is customers who are using the database, no, they will not have any, they will not be using directly, they will not be accessing the database. Okay. They can only see what you permit them to and can select only from the options you give them. So whatever options you are allotted for them, whatever permissions you are giving for accessing the database, only that permissions they can make use of it in order to access the database. If you are restricting for some options, that they cannot able to use, end users cannot able to use in the database. So with this, we will wind up our today's class. Thank you.